This part of the training discusses how to run a CDC light trap. A CDC light trap uses carbon dioxide to attract mosquitoes from far distances, while the light attracts mosquitoes to the trap's fan, which produces a downdraft to capture the mosquitoes in a collection net. Carbon dioxide, or CO2, attracts mosquitoes to a CDC light trap, just as exhaling CO2 attracts mosquitoes to people. Sources for CO2 can be dry ice or a CO2 tank. Carbon dioxide increases trap catch by 400 to 500% and increases the number of mosquito species by 20 to 25%. An option for supplying the trap with CO2 is by using a CO2 gas tank. The CO2 gas tank shown on the right will release CO2 by turning the cylinder valve clockwise to the open position. The regulator shown on the left regulates the airflow coming out of the CO2 tank. The regulator has two gauges. The top gauge is the low pressure gauge, which regulates the amount of airflow from the tank. The side gauge is the high pressure gauge, which is a measure of the tank's capacity. The red knob is the regulator cap. You must pull on the red knob and turn it clockwise to release gas from the tank. For mosquito trapping, the low pressure gauge should be set approximately to 15 psi or pounds per square inch. Before turning the CO2 tank on, insert the green inline orifice connector between the ends of the outlet tubes. To release CO2 gas, turn the cylinder valve counterclockwise to the open position until the high pressure gauge shows a reading. Then pull on the red regulator cap and slowly turn it clockwise until the low pressure gauge reads approximately 15 psi. Do not exceed 20 psi, as this may cause the tubing to shoot from the barb fitting, which may damage the inline orifice connector. Push the red regulator cap in to prevent accidental pressure adjustments. To stop the release of CO2 gas, pull on the red regulator cap and turn it counterclockwise to the off position until the low pressure gauge shows no output. Then turn the cylinder valve clockwise to the closed position. The high pressure gauge will still have a reading. These regulators do not have a manual relief valve. You can bleed the line by unhooking the green inline orifice connector in the tubing, then pull on the red regulator cap and slowly turn it clockwise towards the on position until the gas pressure is released. Then turn the red regulator cap counterclockwise to the off position. If you don't bleed the line, the pressure will slowly decrease on its own once all the CO2 has been expelled from the tubing. Shown here is carbon dioxide being dispensed by a dry ice cooler. CDC light trap models vary in body style, opaque on the left versus transparent on the right. These are nighttime photographs comparing the light produced by opaque and transparent body styles of CDC light traps. A more sturdy, ruggedized CDC light trap with batteries attached to the body of the trap was designed for use in a storm sewer, as shown here. CDC light traps that are equipped with an ultraviolet or black light catch more Culex pipiens, quincampasiatus, and Anopheles mosquitoes, but also catch a lot of non-mosquito insects. Best locations for light traps include areas near known breeding sources, along habitat edges where the tree canopy cover is good and the humidity is high. Keep mosquitoes shaded from the morning sun for two reasons. Firstly, mosquitoes will be desiccated and killed by the sun. Mosquitoes should be captured alive for arbovirus isolation. Secondly, mosquitoes, as well as other insects in the net, become more active in the daylight, resulting in damaged, rubbed specimens that are difficult to identify. When placing a light trap, avoid the following areas. Sites with sources of artificial light. Preferably place traps 30 feet or more away from buildings. Also avoid sites exposed to strong winds, places near buildings that house animals, areas exposed to industrial fumes and smoke, and areas over open water or an open pasture. Suspend light traps so that the trap opening is 5 to 6 feet above ground to capture most mosquito species. Some species will seek a host at different heights. For example, Aedes albopictus might be caught in more numbers if the trap is located as close to the ground as possible. Culex mosquitoes might be caught in more numbers if the trap is hoisted into the tree canopy. For more information on CDC light traps, contact the Medical Entomology Lab at 803-896-3802 or 803-896-0940.